Hi, everybody. It is me, and things are looking up. I think in my last vlog, I was talking about my lack of taste. And since then, it hasn't really gotten any better. But that weekend, that Friday night, I noticed more symptoms. I noticed that when I was talking, my mouth wasn't moving right. And the next morning, Saturday, when we were having our crawfish boil for my birthday, early birthday celebration, I noticed when I put my lipstick on and I went to, you know, do my lips like that, it was crooked and I couldn't get it straight on. And then I noticed that I couldn't blink my right eye, and the muscles on the right side of my face were just weak. So, of course, you know, I kind of figured out what was going on, and that is called Bell's palsy. My younger brother had that one time, and the whole side of his face sagged. And I had a neighbor one time who also had it, and his face sagged. Luckily, mine wasn't real visible because you couldn't really see it. When I smiled real big, you can still see it a little. You can see, you know, the one side doesn't go as far as the other. So it's still, you know, there. I can't blink my eye real, like I can blink. I can't get my eye closed all the way yet. I'm on medication. I'm taking an antiviral. And I did go back to the doctor and I told him, you know, the more symptoms that I had. And he said, yeah. And then he kind of tested me. And he said I had classic symptoms of it. They don't really know what causes it. They think it's a viral thing, a viral infection that presses on the facial nerve and sometimes even damages it. Most times it clears up, usually within a couple of weeks to a month. Sometimes it's permanent, though. And mine already seems to be getting better. The other day, when we had my birthday dinner on Tuesday night, I had a drink, I had some water, and I had a straw, and I went to sip it with the straw, and I couldn't sip it very good. My taste is still off. I hope that comes back. I just, you know, I hope I don't get used to it. I don't like it. Everything kind of tastes like it has a creamy texture to it or something. I don't know. It's hard to describe. But anyway, so I'm taking an antiviral. Because they think, you know, a virus may cause it. The same kind of virus that causes herpes and chickenpox and shingles and stuff like that. So if I had to get something from a virus, I'm glad it's this, and it's very mild rather than something like shingles. So I feel lucky there. The other thing is I'm on prednisone, which is a steroid, but I'm only on it for like 13 days, but it's a tapering dose today, which I have to take it. You have to take it with food, so I had to wait till I ate lunch. And it's late. It's 3:30, and I just finished my lunch. You know, my husband's gone for the whole day. He volunteers taxes, doing people's taxes. He had to go take a class and get certified for that, and he's volunteering doing that. And then he's going to a soccer game tonight. My son and his friend had tickets, but they're going to the rodeo tonight. So they gave the tickets to my husband, and, you know, I didn't want to go. So he's going to go do that. So I'm on my own for today and tonight and for dinner and all of that stuff. But anyway, hopefully... So, you know, I made my own diagnosis, and isn't it funny? You have to kind of do that these days because doctors, you know, they just don't know. It's a guessing game, and I feel like we have to be proactive in our own health care, and, you know, we have the whole internet at our fingertips and tons and tons of information, and sometimes you can get yourself in trouble by, you know, trying to diagnose yourself. But this time I was dead on, and hopefully it'll clear up really soon. The one thing I also wanted to tell you is I finished the baby blanket. I am so excited. And it turned out so cute, and I'm so proud of it. Let me get back here so I can hold it up and show you. I still have to wash it and block it, and I wanted to do that, but I wanted to show it to you first. Can you see it all? And I even put his name on it. Well, actually, that's not his name. Can you see? Oh, wait. See, it's curling up, see, because I have to have to block it so it'll lay flatter. But this is it. It is so cute. I love it. He's going to love it. And but anyway, that... Oh, Mikey. Mikey jumped up in my seat. Anyway, he's going to love it. And it is so soft and nice. And, you know, I love it. His name isn't really Chip. But my niece has been calling him Chip since the day she thought she found out she was pregnant. So they call him Chip, and like Chip off the old block, you know. And so I thought it was just appropriate to put that name on his blanket because that is what they're calling him. So anyway, so I finished that. And so then I had to put away my Charlie socks. This is them, the progress on them. Let's see, I got my yarn all tangled up here. I got as far, I got past the heel. I'm working on the foot part. Everything's backwards. Working on the foot. I think I mentioned, you know, these plain vanilla socks where you just do the stockinette stitch here. These look baggy on my foot. If I'm not mistaken, I think I already showed you this. I haven't done any more because I had to put it away to work on, get on that blanket because we're leaving the 25th, which I guess that's next week or the week after. And I had to get this blanket done because we're going over to Florida. I'm going to see her and I want to take it with me. So I had to get it finished. So I put everything else aside and worked exclusively on the blanket. So then I showed you yarn that I had bought. Do you remember this Vice yarn? It's so beautiful. This one that I got when we were in New Braunfels, Texas. And I decided to do the hitchhiker scarf with it. I started it yesterday. And let me show you. This is as far as I've gotten. Can you? I don't know if you can see. I guess you can see it. I don't know. But anyway, none of the other colors have come in yet. I'm really, really disappointed in that. You know, and it looks like it's going to be a while. See, I'm on the blue, and it looks like it's coming from the bottom. And you can see I got quite a bit more blue in there before it gets to this lighter blue color. And then the purples and the pinks, you know. It's so, I'm not sure I'm exactly happy with it. And then you've got this wiggly yarn because this was already knitted into something, dyed, and then wound, frogged and then wound into this ball. So, but anyway, I'm still gonna work on it and see how it goes. And I love the royal blue though, you know, it's a pretty color. So I'm working on that. And that's the only thing I've picked back up since I finished this baby blanket. That's all I've been doing. So tomorrow, part of one of my birthday presents was a tickets to the Cirque Soleil. I forget the name of the newest one. But anyway, so my husband and I, my son, his wife, and Lawrence, and my other son and a friend are going. And so seven of us are going tomorrow. So I'll be gone most of the day because it starts, at 4:30, and we're going to go to dinner afterwards. And so hopefully my little dog will survive that long without dinner and a potty break. I think he'll do okay. Haven't been doing much else. It's been rainy days and it's been cold. It's supposed to be like 70 though tomorrow. I think it's in the upper 60s today. It's, the weather's been great, but it's still overcast. A little while ago, it was even a little foggy. The bluebirds have been building their nest. I caught the female with pieces of pine needles in her beak, and she was taking them into the nest out there, into the birdhouse. So I guess it's a good time when we're leaving and we're going to be gone a month, so they'll have their babies and be able to wean them and possibly get them out of the nest before we get back. And I let my cats in the backyard because I surely don't want my cats catching one of the babies and killing it, you know, because they will do that. They will do that. And the bluebird, I don't know, he keeps landing on this shepherd's hook where I have my hummingbird feeder hanging right here at this window. And he sits up there and then he flies into the window constantly, off and on, all day long. I don't know why he's doing that. So if anybody has any ideas why birds do that. First I thought, you know, I looked it up before and they say, oh, they see their reflection and they're warning the other bird to get away, you know, that this is their thing. It's their little attack. But that's the only thing I've come up with. So if anybody has any other ideas why they do that, I don't know. But I'm afraid he's going to do it too hard one time and break his neck or something, because I did have a hummingbird do that one time. So, and my windows aren't that clean. They're not that clean. So, you know, they can't think it's open sky. So I don't know. I don't know. Maybe they do. Can't think of anything else that's going on. My hair is looking a mess. It's, you know, I had to cancel my appointment and schedule it for 2 weeks later so that, because otherwise I'd have to go 2 weeks apart in order to be fresh for this trip, you know. So I just canceled the other appointments so that I can just have the one the weekend before we leave. And just get it cut really short so it'll last the whole month. And then I'll have to go again because in 2 weeks after that, we'll be leaving for our long trip. And it'll be a mess. It'll be a mess. So hopefully my taste will come back and I'll be able to taste my food because, you know, when we're on vacation, we eat out all the time mostly. And I really look forward to that and I want to taste my food. So, all right, everybody, it was good talking to you. It's Friday. I hope you all are going to have a good weekend. I hope you had a good week. I hope you're starting to get some spring weather. And, you know, spring's on the way. Talk to y'all soon. Bye.